an angel. It's a miracle.
Your love is like a river, peaceful and deep. Your soul is like a secret that I never could keep. When I look into your eyes, I know that it's true. God must have spared.
Okay, welcome everyone. On behalf of the Bill Thomson charity, thank you for coming. Welcome to the Attorney General Dale Marshall and Thomson, widow to Bill Thomson of the Bill Thomson charity. We have members of the surf community and in particular the US Embassy surf community and the European Union surf community who generously donated to making this bench happen. Damian Brooker from Joe Brooker Builders who built the bench and installation of all the plats. And I mean, wow. Let's give Damian a round of applause. This is amazing work. This came out even better than we even expected. Obviously things like this are not done alone. We always have others to help. And we obviously have people to mention and to thank. I'll start with my lovely wife, Sonia, who conceptualized this whole thing. When I spoke to Mel a few months ago about doing something in memory of Amalee, my wife conceptualized the whole thing about the memorial bench. She designed it with the environment in mind. Have it as coral stone and teak wood to complement the area and just make it a nice area for us to come, all of us, the community members of Tent Bay, Bashabo and Barbados in general, to come here and reflect on the life of Amalee and the inspirations that he's left with us, because without a doubt he was a very inspirational youngster at 16 years old, accomplished so much. So therefore we feel at the Bill Thomson charity that members of the community like Amalee should be remembered, and this is a bench in Amalee's memory and for all of us to use. The coral stone blocks were donated by Coral Block, Graham Manning. The granite plats were donated by Neil Burke at Tile Gallery and AMG, and Damien of course built the bench. A little additional gift that we, the Tomo team, wanted to give to you all the members and family of Amalee, is we wrote an original poem for you which is placed on the bench. And this was done by us, which I'm quite proud of, because I never even thought I'd ever write a poem in my life. And if you don't mind, I would like to read it for you. Amalee, as we sit and reflect on the beauty before, you're the sands of this very shore. You're the salt breeze that blows on through. You're the crashing waves, oh so blue. You're the sounds of the rolling rocks. We are all reminded as the boats dock. Thank you. I'd like to invite the Attorney General, Honorable Dale Marshall, to say a few words.
A year ago, this community was thrown into a state of total and complete despair and total and complete sorrow. We often tell those who are bereaved that the only thing that will heal or that will help them to heal is time. I know truthfully though that there are some wounds that time will never heal, and no matter how many years pass, Melly and Annette will always feel a grief about the passing of Amalee. But in the last year, we've had the opportunity to reflect deeply on the life that he lived. And I believe that in the 16 years that he was on this world, he set an example, not just for people his own age, but an example that all of us should follow. And while it is nice to have memorials like this, if there's one lasting memorial that we could offer for Amalee, is that we should seize life and live our lives in the way that he lived his in his short time with us. His was a life of service in his 16 years, a life of action, a life of participation, and a life that we should all envy. And therefore, I want to commend those of you who have sought to memorialize Amalee's short time on this earth with us. But I ask that the memorialization of him not stop here with this bench, but it should continue for all of us in the example that we set for those of us who we have the opportunity to influence. I am here not as a member of parliament. I am here as a friend, and I too have felt Amalee's loss. I remember those nights holding vigil at Annette's house. Melly just happens to live there. Those nights holding vigil at Annette's house and fighting back the tears myself. But today I think that we haven't healed, but perhaps there's an opportunity to smile a little more broadly because we have still those wonderful memories of Amalee to sustain us. I don't think I could add anything more. Let me thank you all for being here this year, and I hope that next year, this same time, we'll be here again to offer a more lasting memorial.
We have Amalee Mears' dad, Mel, to say a few words, and then the blessing will be done by surfer and pastor Paul Marshall.
Afternoon, everybody. First, on behalf of me and my family, we want to thank everybody for coming here today. Especially Mr. Burke, the Thomson Memorial Trust, the Brooker Construction Firm, American Embassy, for what they have done for us today. And you all can imagine the way how we love it. Just, we really, really appreciate what you all have done for us today. And just want to thank everybody, please.
I'd like to invite surfer Paul Marshall, Pastor Paul Marshall.
It's beyond an honor to be able to ask God to bless this occasion, to bless this location and this bench and the memory of this bench. I've spent my entire life on this part of the island. I am a fellow St. Josephinian, and we love you guys. We love this place, and there's much to be said for what God wants to do here. So with that, let's pray. Father, we thank you for this occasion, that we can come to you and bring our hearts, which are hurting, which are grieving, and you can bring comfort to us. Pray you would bring comfort to the Mears' home, and that the memory of Amalee would be sweet and always cherished and always bring a smile, and you would bring thoughts and memories that would encourage and uplift. I pray this location would be one that your presence would be found, that when people sit here, they would sense your presence, Father. And it would be a place where hurting hearts would be healed by you, that your love would speak to them. Lord, we lift this location to you. We ask you to bless it. Bless all those who participated and contributed to it. And be with our little nation, Lord. We need you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Late Amalee Mears. Words are not enough to express the sincere thanks and gratitude we have for you for what you would have done for us today. You took your idea and you made it into, you transformed it into a reality, giving us not just a memorial bench, but creating an entire atmosphere where we, the family, as well as the members of the community, would be able to find solid.
Trumpeteer?
Yes, sir!
I got it right? Trumpeteer?
Trumpeter.
And this is, pardon?
Trumpeter.
Trumpeter and not trumpeter. So you are?
Amalee Mears.
Amalee Mears. Tell us about your instrument. What's your love affair with this instrument?
Well,
who inspired you to play the trumpet?
Well, Mr. Mora and Mr. Jelani.
Jelani, right. Good. So how does it feel being a part of this group?
It's wonderful being a part of this group. And everyone in the pop band is very experienced at what they do.